taken into number two. She is picking up the speed. Take it down to third number two, while number three is in your sight. Turn and turn, my friend. Or Twyla, your time, 24.45. The great thing about this event is if you just have one Clydesdale at home, you don't have a car or you don't have a wife, just set up some barrels and you too can make it to the next world show in the barrel race. Absolutely. Next will be number 420. That is the entry of Dan Jones. Mary doing the riding. Mary's on a smaller horse. This horse could be real fast. Here she goes, Mary. You're making me busy. And she's hitting the barrel number one. She's getting close. Oh! Little penalty here. I might mention that they can go to either barrel first. If they go to the right barrel first, they make one right and two left. If they go to the left barrel first, like she did, they make one left and two right. And here's the home stretch. Well, we did have to add some time on there. A 5-second addition. It was 27-12.5. And Pam, I think if they can catch that barrel with their foot or their hand, it's still a straight barrel.
Yes, you're not penalized from taking a hold of the barrel and setting it back up.
All right, number 282, Kim Nader's entry will be next.
I might mention that this is Katie Hoffman's favorite event.
Absolutely. Barrel number one, a little wide, but we have cleared the barrel. Oh, I'm sorry, this is number 554, Rihanna Hoyt. She is now going down to barrel number three. And bring it home, Rihanna. A time of 29.14. Now, again, Pam, that wasn't our fastest time, but she seemed to have a lot of style in the way she rode.
You know, you want to see a horse that makes an arc around the barrel. If they keep that momentum and they kind of think they're supple and they're ribbed, so that's the things that they work on at home is to get that horse deflection of front end. If they're supple around that barrel, they'll pick up some valuable seconds.
Do you foresee that we can maybe talk to guys at the end of bar and get some flight sales in there?
Not sure.
All right, number 827, Andrew Merrill's entry. All right, two barrels are cleared. A little wide there, a little wide note. She's taken into the third barrel. And she's ready to bring it home. Bring it home. I'm still going to say the Canadians are taking home the gold so far.
That 24.45 is still in the lead, but there's still a few more to go. We want to make sure that we encourage those riders to go all the way through that electric eye because those are valuable seconds as well if they pull up short of that finish line. So just like in a horse race, you want to make sure that they cross that finish line before you start pulling up.
All right, Cindy Malley, riding for Cobalt Pleasure, number 1051 is next. She's in it to win it. Look at this young lady. A little wide, but a clear barrel. A little wide, but maybe that one. Down to the third barrel.
Spin and win, my friend. As she makes her way around, we will have to bring you home. A time of 30.5. Well, fam, I always wondered this because we've done a lot of shows together. We did the American down in Texas. And some of those girls, they're going so fast when they hit the gate to stop. Has there ever been anyone that didn't get stopped in time and kind of has a little smash and crash?
Well, a lot of girls don't even have a gate. They actually let you run up the alley. So it is a challenge for those girls to get the horses stopped. And yeah, there's been more than one wreck.
Here we go. Is there anyone else? Double D flies. Dancing around barrel number two. She made it. She pushes it up. All right, in our first saddle, Lord Gamble. $29.79 her time.
Imagine how fast she was in, and she wouldn't have had that refusal if that barrel tried to go on the wrong side. She was going for it. She ran in and ran it out the gate.
Oh, I had it.
I don't know how to do this, but getting a head start is the key. Crossing as fast as you can. Next in is number 196, my buddy, the young hot century. We are? I think we're having a ball. I almost think it would be fun to get out there and try this, but we're going to let the experts do it. We're seeing if we have any more riders. Oh, there's our next rider. All right, this rider looks pretty serious. Here we go, Pam. She is in it to win it. Whoops, a little wide. Down to the second barrel. This just shows the facility and the versatility and the willingness to please their riders. And that's what everybody here at the Clydesdale Roadshow says.
Thank you.